Hello friends, so today's video is going to be one of those informational videos. Today we are going to find out how to check whether a spark plug is good or not. For instance, this plug basically came with the Shaolin that I bought, and this is the plug out of my running RxZ. Okay, so before we dive into the technique behind or how to check whether it's a working plug or not, what we will do is we will understand some basic terminologies about the spark plug and what these numbers basically mean. Okay, so as you can see, it says NGK here. NGK is the brand. Then there is a BP6H. So right now we don't know what that is. We'll come to that. This basically says BPR7HS. This is also an NGK plug, but it has an R. So what that basically means is this is a resistance or a resistor plug. Okay, so this plug has a resistance inside. So what that actually does is, because of that resistance, these kind of plugs with resistance don't do any kind of interference with the rest of the machine. So let's say in a car, maybe if you put a non-resistor plug, you might have noticed sometimes, when you rev your car, you can hear the sound in the radio. So that is basically interference which gets produced when the spark is generated. So that is why the R is there, and you can see this is a non-resistor kind of a plug. So this is a normal plug, this is a resistance plug. So basically this interference can also cause interference with the ignition system, and it can basically affect the performance of the vehicle. That's why we use a plug with a resistor in it. Okay, so that's the basic thing. This is where you connect the output of the high tension coil. So this is where the plug cap comes in. So this is the electrode. Basically what this electrode does is, imagine that this electrode goes from here till here. In the middle there is a small cut where that resistance is connected. In this, the electrode goes from here to the tip. There is no resistance in between. Okay, and whatever you see here, this metal part till the metal part which is slightly curved here, all this is basically the ground part. So there is no connection between this metal part and this tip, unless if the gap is really small, and if it is touching, then that gets connected, and then there will be a short which can blow up a lot of stuff. Like you can damage your CDI, you can damage your high tension coil, you can damage the rest of the coils also in the bike. So basically the gap in the plug is very important, and this plug gap is basically something that is responsible for the spark to jump from the positive electrode to the ground. Okay, so that is very important. Please note that down. If you have any confusion, replay this video, you will, till the time it gets clear to you. So basically the spark jumps between the positive electrode and the ground. This tip is the ground, and the tip that you see inside, which I am touching with this, is the positive electrode. Okay, so this gap depends on the bike that you have. It is mentioned in the owner's manual, it is also mentioned in the workshop manual, service manual. So most of our viewers already have all those service manuals there. They have access to all the service manuals that I have kept in our shared drive. In case if you would like to get those, you can follow our channel on the Instagram, and then I can provide you that link. The details of the Instagram is in the description. Okay, so now we have understood how the spark travels. Now basically to adjust this gap, we need something called a feeler gauge. Okay, the feeler gauge are some metal pieces with variable thickness. So as per the recommended thickness, what we can do is we can basically put the feeler gauge in between the tip and the electrode, and then gently tap this to reduce the gap. If we need to increase the gap, then we can use a plier to slightly increase it, put the feeler gauge correct size, and then slightly tap it so that It fits snug, not extremely tight, and you are able to move the feeler gauge freely, but still it is touching both the ends. Okay, so that's how you gap a plug. Now let's get into the main thing, which is, you know, the plug as such and how, you know, it can get damaged. So one thing that can happen is this ground electrode can get in contact with the positive electrode, and when that happens, the, you know, due to you know, arcing happening inside the plug, the insides of the plug might get burnt. So that is one thing. Second thing that can happen is it can get fouled by various, you know, like carbon deposit, too much of oil can foul it. So that can also cause, you know, it from sparking. Then there is corrosion that can happen on the tip, because of which sparking can cause a problem. And then there is a very particular thing that can happen if the plug is of a wrong type. Then, you know, it can basically cause a lot of heat buildup, and due to which the electrodes can get damaged. So now we will come to these numbers that is mentioned here. Okay, so you can say, see, this says BPR, R is for resistance, then it says 7 H's, this says 6 H. So basically what the 6 and 7 denote is the whether the plug is hot or cold. So this plug is relatively hotter to this plug. Higher the number, the plug is colder, and it basically is something that depends on the environment that you are in and the cleaning capability of the plug. The plug automatically has a cleaning mechanism inside. So if you are, let's say, running a colder plug in a cold region, then, you know, cleaning might not happen properly. So this number will reduce in a place like Kashmir, or let's say Ooty, or let's say Kodaikanal, or any hill station which is at higher elevation and little colder. So there you will use a hot plug. But in case if you are in a hotter place like where I am at the moment, Kerala Trivandrum, so you will use a colder plug there. And also, you know, depending on the engine that your this plug goes into, the temperature needs to be as per the engine as well. So usually the 7 H's comes in RX 100 135, the 8 H's goes in RD 350. So that's how you select the plug. So it's always good to have a resistor plug, because, you know, that would reduce interference. But this plug is a non-resistor type. Now, even though I can tell you right now without testing that this plug is not good, and that's the reason why I brought this to show it to you. But the funny part is this plug actually, when connected, will create a spark. So, you know, most of the people, when they see the spark, they think that, okay, it's not the plug. They look at other things. They replace the CDI, they replace the rest of the coil. They then, you know, replace the high tension coil. They chase ground on the bike. So there are multiple things that people go behind without checking the spark plug. So this is very important. So since, you know, the voltage is like 20,000 volt of you know, current comes through this electrode, so even if there is a break inside, it will still jump and there will be a spark produced here. The only difference would be the strength. So bike might not start, it might be fluttering, or it might be misfiring. So all that can happen due to the plug. So this is the first thing that you should check. So now how can you check that is, basically you need a multimeter like what I have, and I have put this into the resistance checking, and I have put it at the 20K resistance. Okay, so now to check the plug, what you do is you connect one end of the plug to the multimeter lead and the other end to the electrode inside. Okay, so not the outer one, that is ground, but inside. And you click, you know, when you connect this, there is nothing happening. Okay, but if you, let's say, connect here, you can see there is value, because this is all ground. Okay, see, on the tip also a value will come and go, like you can see now. Okay, but there is no value when you're connecting the electrode. So basically this plug is gone bad. Okay, and if you, let's say, connect here and you connect anywhere on the plug, on the body, anywhere, it should not show any value. Okay, now this is our good plug. So when you are connecting the electrode inside with the multimeter lead, and when you are connecting this end, you can see there is a value. So anything between 5 to 15 is okay. So 5 basically is not 5 ohms, it is basically 5k ohms, because I put it in 20k. So this is a 5k plug and it is giving you the right reading. Okay, so that means it is basically working fine. So that's how it works. So basically this is ceramic, so this basically isolates this electrode and the outer ground part. So that's how you check the plug. If you have any questions, feel free to comment. If you like the video, please share it with your friends. If you have not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel. And I hope this was an informational video. So first thing that you do is you check your plug before you start taking apart anything from your ignition system. The plug is bad, throw it away, buy a new one. No amount of cleaning can fix this plug, because the electrode is broken inside. That's how you check. But this plug, like you can see, is working absolutely fine. It's giving the same reading again and again. So that's how, folks, you check for a working plug. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.